the heroes of Inc. magazine are never people who started an obvious business and built it to enormous scale. It is always someone who started something their mother-in-law said was a stupid idea, who made it for a few people, and then maybe it spread. That if you think about a podcast, every single podcast that has ever launched has launched with fewer than 100 listeners. How could it not? It's only after those 100 people tell other people that it starts to spread. And so what we get to do is say, I am here to help. Who is enrolled in where I would like to go, needs what I do, and will pay money to have this problem solved? Now, in this moment, fewer people are paying less money for almost everything. But that doesn't mean no one is. I was talking to a small business owner in Ohio. He runs a business called Chef's Table. Chef's Table made a living for years and years selling 7,000 different kinds of fruits and vegetables to fancy restaurants. Like if you want purple basil that's this big, they would grow you a little tiny plot of it. And he told me that last week they got more orders in a single day than any day since they opened the business. Not one from a chef. Because what they said is there's a whole bunch of people who are used to paying X number of dollars in a restaurant, and they're going to pay half that to cook themselves dinner tonight. I'll ship directly to them. Is business better than ever? No way. No way, because his margins are much smaller. But he just discovered with a pivot that there are people who want something that he can bring them. Whether or not that's a viable business going forward is unknown, right? The real question I'm asking people is, if you got out of your own head about where you are, your stuckness, your need, the burning of having to pay back whatever bills you have to pay, and said instead, who is it that I can help today? What story can I tell to people who trust me, then you can go solve a problem. Now, if you don't have trust, then you're going to be inclined to go race for attention. And the problem with racing for attention is that's sort of like spamming people. Social media loves it when people race for attention because that's how they make a living. Hit the boost button. They make a living tricking you into thinking that like means someone likes you and that friend means someone is your friend. They're not. That these intermediaries want you to race around trying to scam and hustle and hype attention. When in fact, we need to spend more time saying, who exactly am I here for?